So, how do you replant? Ow. Something with a million thorns. Pachypodium lemurii, the Madagascan palm. We'll show you how we go about repotting this baby without bleeding, or at least without bleeding too much. Okay, so we'll also show you what media we use and how we go about the whole process. So hopefully this won't be too painful. So welcome to the Nature Company. If this is the kind of information you're interested, please hit that subscribe button and that notification bell down below to be notified of all our upcoming videos, so we keep you up to date on all the best practices to look after your babies. The reason we're repotting our Pachypodium is because he's so root bound, it's beginning to affect his growth and stunt it. So what we want to do is have a look around and see why. We can see the bulging pot, all the roots escaping out the bottom. And the large crack on the side. So you definitely know that it's time to repot this. How are we going to do it without breaking ourselves and all the thorns? We get ourselves ready with a nice large container that we can put it straight into. Okay, now it's a bit top heavy. I don't have the thing. So let's just use our foot to hold it upright. And then our good old trusty dog blanket. Sorry, flower. So all we do is we carefully wrap them up in the dog blanket. And now suddenly we can hold them well without being hurt. And also, we're not going to break all the thorns off. So let's see if we can get this pot off. So because of the rounded bottom of the excess roots at the bottom of the pot, just using my bag of compost to stabilize the pot in my big container. And now we're going to have to cut away our plastic pot. Because it's so bulging from the root mass, it's not going to be possible to save the pot. Just even a good solid old pair of garden shears will also do the work. So we've haphazardly cut our way around through the pot as best we can. And what we'll do is we'll spin the pot around now and do the next cut. There we go. We're gonna aim for cutting here. We can just slip the pot apart. And yay, ants! So now we've got to contend with being bitten by ants and being bitten by the plant. With this ant infestation, we're going to have to figure out another plan. So I'll grab a few more blankets, and that way we can remove it completely. Okay, so lying it down is going to be the next best bet. And then we can get in underneath, cut the pot away from the roots that are going through the holes, so we can try and save as many of those as possible. So to avoid as much of this mess as possible, we'll move up. Big basket back into position. You see how tight and bound this is. Okay, at least we've got a nice amount of covering that we can put some pressure on here without breaking ourselves or the plant. And then again, just taking our handy fork weeder just to loosen up around the top. We want to get rid of all these weeds. Oh, solid as a rock. We'll just go in gently and wedge it around. We can see all the ferns roots that are stuck in between holding all the soil together and causing problems for the plant. Okay, now getting the media ready for the pot. What we're going to be using is this nice river sand. So what we're basically going to be doing is using three parts of this river sand. To one part of this good quality fine compost. And then just to add a bit of lightness to the mix, we're going to be adding in some perlite. So for the perlite, we're doing a half part for the full mix. So there we go. Now we have our nice, well, evenly mixed media. The reason that there's so much river sand is to ensure that the drainage is excellent. We add the extra perlite not only for the lightness that it brings to the mix, but also for the moisture that it's going to hold. Because strangely enough, Pachypodium lemerii do like quite a bit of water, especially during the growing season. So it's to help keep the heavy dampness away from the roots, but still allow the moisture in the media. So let's get to potting. So we'll just fill up some media into the bottom of the pot. For one, the river sand is going to give it that extra weight that it needs, so that it's not going to get top heavy too quickly. The weight of the pot is going to help keep it stable. And what we're looking again is we want to pot it to the same level that it was originally, so that none of the root system that was out above the ground is then covered by the soil again. This is just to help those hardened off parts stay hardened off and not suddenly realize they've got too much moisture and then decide they want to rot. So we'll just centralize. Also, the nice thing about the sand media is it fills up in amongst the roots really easily. If you find you damage your roots while you removing it from the previous pot and taking off all the soil, then I would suggest the best idea would then be to leave your plant out in the open
in a semi-shaded spot with the roots out, allowing them to dry up, allowing those areas to heal up. You can leave it out for as much as a week so that those parts can really be calloused over properly and no infection can take place. Also, you can use a little bit of cinnamon on them just to help the whole process, because these are very susceptible when the soil stays soggy for too long to rotting. So that's one of the reasons that we use this mix as well, to allow for that almost immediate drainage. So best to be placed out in the full sun where your pot can dry out quickly and the water and rain can get to it as well. So let's derobe it to check that it's straight enough, and then we can wrap it around again if we need to. One owl, not bad. Gently removing the cloth off so we don't strip off the thorns as we do it. Also, with our pachypodiums, we're not going to go around putting bark mulch and stuff around the top of them. We want that evaporation to take place. We can use things like pebbles and that are going to allow that heat to build up so that the evaporation can still take place, but not things like bark, which are going to hold the moisture in the soil for too long. So if you want to just keep it neat, then you'd rather use something like pebbles. The black pebbles will do excellently, but any of them will really be fine. By doing this, I'm not compacting the soil in, I'm not pushing hard. I'm just pushing in the sand around the roots. This pot is a little bit big for me to pick up and shake, otherwise I would have done it that way. And naturally a little bit dangerous. There we go. Pachypodium lemuria repotted. No deaths occurred. I'm mostly intact, and more importantly, planters. I call that a win. And of course, our slow release organic fertilizer pellets. We're going to sprinkle around the top afterwards. The roots can be fairly sensitive to fertilizers, so I prefer to just put them on top, and when the rain comes, it will start slowly releasing the fertilizer ingredients into the plant. And we all saw how easy it was to replant a 15-year-old Pachypodium lemuria that has been never transplanted before. In just two easy steps, it's up in a brand new pot and it's going to be looking fabulous soon. Never trust a YouTuber. But it's safe, it's happy, and it's going to grow well, so all is good. And if this is the kind of information you enjoy, please hit that like button, the subscribe button down below, and of course that notification bell, bing bong, to be notified of all our upcoming videos so that you never miss another one. Help us grow as we help your plants grow.